A History of England by Charles Dickens. Audiobook 16x30. Jack, in imitation of Wat Tyler, though he was a very different and inferior sort of man, addressed the Kentish men upon their wrongs, occasioned by the bad government of England, among so many battledores and such a poor shuttlecock, and the Kentish men rose up to the number of 20,000. Their place of assembly was Blackheath, where, headed by Jack, they put forth two papers, which they called the Complaint of the Commons of Kent, and the Requests of the Captain of the Great Assembly in Kent. They then retired to Sevenoaks. The royal army coming up with them here, they beat it and killed their general. Then, Jack dressed himself in the dead general's armor, and led his men to London. Jack passed into the city from Southwark, over the bridge, and entered it in triumph, giving the strictest orders to his men not to plunder. Having made a show of his forces there, while the citizens looked on quietly, he went back into Southwark in good order, and passed the night. Next day, he came back again, having got hold in the meantime of Lord Say, an unpopular nobleman. Says Jack to the Lord Mayor and judges, "Will you be so good as to make a tribunal in Guildhall, and try me this nobleman?" The court being hastily made, he was found guilty, and Jack and his men cut his head off on Cornhill. They also cut off the head of his son-in-law, and then went back in good order to Southwark again. But, although the citizens could bear the beheading of an unpopular lord, they could not bear to have their houses pillaged. And it did so happen that Jack, after dinner, perhaps he had drunk a little too much, began to plunder the house where he lodged, upon which, of course, his men began to imitate him. Wherefore, the Londoners took counsel with Lord Scales, who had 1,000 soldiers in the Tower, and defended London Bridge, and kept Jack and his people out. This advantage gained, it was resolved by divers great men to divide Jack's army in the old way, by making a great many promises on behalf of the state, that were never intended to be performed. This did divide them, some of Jack's men saying that they ought to take the conditions which were offered, and others saying that they ought not, for they were only a snare, some going home at once, others staying where they were, and all doubting and quarrelling among themselves. Jack, who was in two minds about fighting or accepting a pardon, and who indeed did both, saw at last that there was nothing to expect from his men.